Hey everyone, it's Trading Aloha with Avalaunch, and starting today, I'm going to start making some tutorials on how to start playing and getting involved with the GameFi space within the Avalaunch ecosystem. The current bear market's really crushed us all over the last couple of months, and the climate's caused a lot of concern and frustration on a macro level. However, if you take a look at GameFi and where it's come and where it's going to go over the next couple of years, I think now is a great time to get involved with some of the projects that we know are going to continue to build through the current cycle. And the cost of entry has come down quite a bit from where it used to be a couple months ago. So the games are quite affordable and they're not promising sky high APR and returns, which I think is great. So right now is a great time to get familiar with GameFi if you're new, and also find games that you like that could potentially earn you a little money on the side while we kind of chop through this bear market and help you become more knowledgeable on all things GameFi and the Avalaunch ecosystem. And hopefully we can all continue to push forward and get ready for the next bull run, whenever that may come, if it's next couple months or in 2024 with the next Bitcoin halving. But I'm hoping to assist you all with the intro into some of these games if you're not familiar with them over the coming months. And then in additional follow-on videos, we'll take a look at, you know, going on to strategy and some of the more successful games that you could potentially earn a little bit more by doing certain things. So to start the series off, I wanted to touch on Snail Trail, which is one of the games that, you know, was hyped up early on. I had a couple of delays, ended up launching in April, in about mid-April, I think, is when their whitelist launches, and the prices, and it immediately sold out. The prices were sky high on secondary. There's five different tiers of snails, and we saw that the tier one, the highest level snail, the Atlantis version, selling over 30 AVAX for weeks. So now that prices have come down and, you know, the token slime is trading in a pretty relative range here, I think now is a great time to take a look at, you know, where Snail Trail is, where it's going, and how you can get involved, getting your first snail, getting it out on the trails, earning a little bit of slime, and then seeing where the team takes it, because they're starting to continue to develop out their roadmap. And we'll talk about that too. So, you know, I don't want to make these long and drawn out. I just want to help get everyone involved. So let's take a look. You know, going to the snailtrail.art is their main website here. Pretty straightforward. You can jump into their Discord. The team is on pretty much all the time, and there's people in there that chat quite often. So if you have any questions at any hours, you can always jump in the Discord and you know, start asking questions. So, you know, it kind of walks you through like what it is. It's the first play-to-earn racing game on Avalaunch. You use your in-game NFTs, which are the snails, for the assets. There is free to earn, basically, you start off with, and you can earn without having to pay much, but just a single transaction fee at times. However, there is gasless entries that we'll go over to. So once you buy a snail, your cost can be zero if you just want to play the free game. And there's also paid entry races as well. There's breeding that's involved that we can go over as well in a follow-on video, because there's a lot of intricacies with the genes and on how that works out. But, you know, just to start off, I recommend just looking at a snail or two and then, you know, going from there. So, you know, kind of as I talked about earlier, there's five different classes of snails, from Garden to Atlantis, and within each, you know, they don't just race within their division. It's based on their ELO ranking, which we'll talk about. So, you know, find a snail that looks good for you. The roadmap, which they're working through right now, we're already over down through Q1 and Q2 here. We've taken up pretty much all of that, and then we are just waiting for kind of the follow-on to this roadmap, since they've hit most all of their initial targets. So, you know, taking a look at how do you get involved. So, you know, you've got AVAX in your wallet, you're ready to buy. It's pretty simple. You can get them on multiple marketplaces. You can go to NFT Trade. You can go onto JPEGs. Pretty much any, you know, marketplace within Avalaunch does have these for listed. But they also do have their own native marketplace that are available. And you can see it's some 35,000 AVAX worth of volume. So they are still selling today. There's only a 1% marketplace fee, so that's pretty solid as when you compare it to its competitors. And then if you can see, you can see the floor for each type of snail that's available, and these have all pretty much come down and gotten to the point where they're all pretty much leveled off. When the launch first happened, you saw the Garden floor, I think it was around 3 or 4 AVAX, and then there was a huge jump on the Atlantis floor up to 30, 35 AVAX for a while, until, you know, kind of the whole market came crashing down, and we've seen prices kind of normalize here. So you can really go anywhere. What you really want to look at here is you want snails. If you're looking at genes, that's going to be for breeding purposes only, and the cost is in slime. and we'll cover that in an additional video, but you have to focus on the basics here. When you're looking at a snail, you're gonna look at what kind of class it is. You'll see on the left-hand side if the snail can be used to breed or not. This is a recently added indicator that can help kind of narrow that down. And then also what their adaptation advantage is, which will help when you're selecting a race to get into. It helps them, their average speed be higher. So really, honestly, it doesn't matter at this point when you're looking at, you know, visuals. The rarities don't come into play as far as a more rare snail or a less rare snail as far as attributes goes. That's all for visual. What you want to focus on, one, is what class you're looking at, and then two, what adaptations and what level they are. So, you know, some you'll see have two, and that's because these snails have been raced a certain amount of time and have gained enough experience to the point where they've leveled up a couple of times. And as you level up, you'll unlock their additional adaptations, which will help you kind of identify which races you want to pay to get into, to where your average results will usually be higher. So just taking a look at a basic one, for example, we'll say Nonsense here. You just click on him, it'll bring up his basic profile. It'll show you what family he's a part of. He's a garden snail, the class that he's a part of, which is Master. He's a Generation 3 snail with a 10 purity. And here are his gene breakdowns, which, you know, correspond to the class of snail that they are. So G, Garden, M, Milk, H, Helix, A is Agate, and X is the Atlantis gene. And then currently what level they are, their experience points needed to rank up to the next one, and then which adaptation they are best on for what kind of course to race on. And as it says here, as you continue to level up, you'll unlock the following two adaptations. So like I said before, the visuals, as far as, you know, what this is, the brown cow snail shell, doesn't make a difference when you come to speed and race results, just kind of how you like your snail to look. And then if it's been bred before, you know, when it can breed again, how many times it's done, and then overall statistics. So as you can see, this snail has been raced 101 times. It's got a ranking of 1549, which puts it in the gold class. There's two classes to race in, gold and platinum. We'll go over that too. It's currently earned 618 slime altogether. And of the times it's raced, it has been in the top three 34% of the time, and one races 8% of the time. And you can see where the final positions are. So what it doesn't show you, so this, when you click on show more stats, it'll basically tell you how many times each distance track has been raced. And when you see treasury run, this is the free races. So this snail has only been run in the free races 101 times. So this snail has earned 618 slime without actually having to pay any transaction fees to enter. So that's not bad. If a snail had been raced in paid races, you'd see distances here and then what their average time to completion is. But let's just hitting all the main stuff here. We go back up to, you know, the profile. So what is Master, Generation, and Purity? So to do that, you know, you're gonna have to go into the white paper itself, and it tells you exactly kind of how that breaks out. So, you know, there's classes and generations. The Master class is the one level down from the Genesis is what the only available for the mint. And then as you breed and continue to go down, the class type can continue to get diluted, if you want to put it that way, and that can keep going down. So that'll have an effect on your average speed potentially. The overall classification on how the formula is decided for the snail speed is kept pretty much under lock and key and only available to the dev team. And each season that completes, they change it up a little bit and only release the previous versions one for audit and checking purposes. But this kind of shows you how the generations are built off of breeding. So it's a very complicated process, an algorithm that has its whole separate video and document that is hard to go over in one sitting. So we'll leave it at the racing part of it. And then your adaptation, as we saw earlier, it's basically broken into three different types. The first one is the type of trail that you're racing on: desert, mountain, beach, classic, forest, or space. And then weather, and then athletics. So I'll show you how that makes sense in a few seconds. So, you know, once you, a snail is born, it has one adaptation, and then it will unlock two as you gain more experience. So here's how you level up your snail. So for experience, every time you do a daily mission, you get 5 experience points. If you are the last snail to join a race, the way it saves gas is there's 10 snails that join a race. Snails 1 through 9 can join without paying any gas. The last snail that joins the race has to pay the gas transactions to start the race, which is very minimal, but that snail get extra experience for being the one that has to pay the gas. So they kind of give you a little bonus there. And then the experience goes up as you start playing competitive races. You get 10. If you breed as a male or female, you get more. A lot of the names have been set on your snail, but if you happen to buy one and name it, you get 10 extra. And then here's the bonus that you get for being the last snail. So instead of 5, if you're paying the gas transaction, you get 30, which is pretty solid if you're trying to level up a snail quickly to pay that. And then at level 5, you get your second adaptation, and then level 15, you get that third one. And so once you have your snail, so we'll go back to, you know, the marketplace, and we'll say, you know, we bought some snails, and then you'll be able to come into the game itself. And this is what you'll see when you log in, your wallet's connected, it'll be up here. You'll see missions, daily missions, which are the free missions that you can join. And then you will be able to pick, you know, what you look for, the conditions, which is the adaptations that your snail has. And you're gonna try to find the one that matches you. So I have a couple of snails loaded that I've been working on leveling up. I know that mine are, I have a forest and a wet. So this shows you that there's already 9 of 10 snails entered in this daily race, and you can see below who they are, their ranking currently, what class they are, their generation, and what adaptation you're up against. So for me, I would click on that. It shows me that I've got, you know, which snails I want to enter. Since it has the forest and the wet, I do like to race driving with Dengue, who is one of my favorite snails, in there. So you just hit queue up. I will have to sign saying that, yes, I want to race. I'm the last snail to race, so I have to pay. And it costs 0.00949 AVAX total with gas, which is not bad considering what the price of AVAX is. It'll go through its cycle. I have successfully joined the race. So now it'll update and say that I'm the 10th person in there. So what if I want to watch the race, I can go into next to run. You can change it to my races. And once it updates, there it is. So the race itself will start in 1 minute and 54 seconds. So since we're doing this live, I figure it might as well, you know, go through the whole process. It'll do it automatically, and you can check your results later if you want to, but just kind of show you exactly what the interface looks like. We'll kind of wait this out and see exactly what happens and who wins. While we do that, so to get your ELO, which is listed here, when you first have a snail, if you breed one, you're going to see your you don't have an ELO, and that's because you're not assigned to a league yet. And to be assigned to a league, you have to race 5 free races first, and then your average placing in those races will determine your ELO, and your ELO is what decides what competitive class you're going to be in. So as I said, you know, there's platinum and gold, and then there's entrance fees for all of these at different levels and different adaptations, and we'll kind of look at that in a second. But let's jump into the snail race itself. So there is a 2D version that you can watch, and then there's currently in development on a 3D version. So we'll jump into the 2D one since we're about to start here, and see where we end up as far as a placement. So once you pop into the actual interface itself, you'll see your snails lined up here, 1 through 10. Once the timer goes down, I'll be able to click on my snail, which I think is number 4 here from what I remember him looking like. And once you click on your snail, it'll keep it centered on yours so you don't lose track of where they are on the field as the race goes on. The camera zooms out and you may not be able to see your snail. So if you want to keep track of just where yours is, you can always click on it And it'll show you where it's at. Yep, so number four, that's me. Sometimes it takes a second. There we go. So on the bottom left, you'll see how many meters left till race completion. And on the right-hand side, it tells you basically what the adaptations were of the mission that you selected and the name of it. And then on the left-hand side, it'll update results and placement as the race goes on. So as you can see, we are getting destroyed currently, but we're making a little push here. Come on, driving, let's go. Don't make me lose on my first recording. So it looks like we're about halfway done. So they also started streaming these on Twitch as of the other day that are currently going 24/7. They're gonna be using some special events as well on Twitch when they start doing some special races. So keep an eye out for that in Discord and on Twitter. As we come into the last 7 meters here, I am not doing too good. Looks like we're gonna finish in the back half of the pack here. Come on, get up there. We might finish dead last. Good showing. No, we finished 8th. So on a free race, if I wasn't the last one to join, it would have cost me nothing. You'll see that I still earned 3 slime tokens for finishing under 5th. First being 15, second being 12, third being 9, fourth being 6, and then the rest get 3. So, you know, no matter what happens, you still end up with some slime. Ideally, you'd want to be in the top 4 to keep stacking slime up. But, you know, it's not a bad thing to just get a couple slime here and there, especially when it doesn't cost you anything to enter the race itself. So once that's complete, there is a 4-hour timer on the free races that before you can enter your next one. So just take that into consideration. So you could technically, if you don't sleep, enter 5 races a day. But, you know, realistically, you're probably going to enter 3 or 4. So the max you could probably earn anywhere between, you know, 60 and what, 75 probably is realistic slime tokens a day if you have a stellar snail that wins constantly, which isn't bad for, you know, a free entry. Roughly, you know, depending on what you pay for your snail at, from what we saw on the marketplace, is roughly between like 1 and 1.5 AVAX. It probably take you between, you know, 65 to 80 days to ROI on that, based on the current slime token prices and AVAX price. And that's not doing any of the competitive racing and earning that way, or breeding and selling snails that way, which is also an option. So, you know, the ROI is not bad. Personally, I think it's a good thing that we're not in games anymore that look to ROI in 15 to 30 days, which is just not sustainable and realistic for any type of investment, let alone a game or DeFi platform. I think what we need to move on to is more games that are, you know, you slowly earn over time, keeps you interested, keeps you invested. You're not trying to just dump on everybody. And this is, I think, a good time to start that now, where you can, you know, have a couple snails, have some fun with it. You're not stressed out. There's no concern about getting dumped on or trying to make thousands of dollars fast. But, you know, it's just a good thing to play with, and it's fun, you know, just a time killer. But, you know, once you get through your rankings and all the other good stuff, and you're ready to, you know, race competitively, and you want to use some of that free slime that you earned to enter some of these bigger races, you can just pop over to the competitive tab. You can change your ELO, league that you're in, based on your ELO. And most of my snails are in gold because that's where they ended up, and they haven't been the greatest, but they're still pretty good. And then as you go, this is where it kind of differs from the free races. So as you start racing outside the treasury run free races, your snail has a preferred track length that you just don't know. And you can only find out through really trial and error. So you're going to want to try to focus on 1 or 2 snails that you own and just try different distances that match your adaptations. And run them 2 or 3 times each and see which ones they perform at the best. And once you find it, you will start noticing that your win rate will go up on those certain tracks because everything lines up with the way it's supposed to and what's behind the hidden formula, and you'll start winning more. And you can find that out if you're looking at the marketplace and you're trying to figure out, you know, is there a snail that has already been through the ELO process. It's been raced a ton of times, and there's some history there. There is a third-party site that's been developed that actually helps kind of break that out. So I'll just show it real quick on one of my snails, my snail 2633. You know, I've raced them a couple times, 143 times in the treasury, and then I have started kind of experimenting on, you know, what his best distance is, where I could only race him in those paid races with the right adaptations so that he has a higher chance of winning. That way my overall income per day is higher when I catch those races. And for me, it's been a distance of 15, between 12 and 15, where he starts winning more. I've only raced it twice, and he's finished in the top three the one time I've raced it. And then I've raced the 15 seven times, and he's won it once and came in the top three twice. And so far, I'm kind of net positive on those two entries. So it's a good way to kind of start looking at exactly where your snail performs out the best. The more data you have, obviously, the better it's going to be. When you start looking at those, you know, there are in the gold, especially in the gold class, you know, you can look to enter, try to hit the ones that are 50 slime, and just do those as many times as you can to try to get that data. So that way you can see exactly where you perform the best before you start throwing your snail for his first time racing a 24 meter course for 200 slime. You don't end up burning through like days worth or weeks worth of free races that you've earned slime on and then coming dead last. That can be frustrating, because I've done it to try to experiment on some of that stuff. And then on the platinum league, if your ELO is high enough, you know, you'll see the same kind of stuff available. You're just racing against, you know, faster snails, you know, with a higher ranking. So outside of that, you know, you see your results from your last races in the results tab. You just click it back to my races, and then you can see all the ones that I've run, and you can see that, you know, the last paid run I did earlier this morning, so with driving with Dengue, I just finished just outside the top three, which unfortunately in competition races, they only pay the top three, so I did not win any there, but you know, we're getting there. And we'll keep chugging along until something happens. So as far as where is Snail Trail headed to next, and what else is kind of, you know, on the docket for them? So just the other day, about 48 hours ago or so, they made an announcement that for the first time in a while, they fixed some of the bugs that were in the game. That were allowing people to kind of join races twice, but it wasn't really a big issue. They just kind of closed it and made sure everyone knew it was fixed. There's a new race mode that's under development. It's going to take a while to come out, but it's there, so they are still chugging along there, which is nice to see the continued development while also, you know, going through the current market situation. And then they also announced the launch of their 24/7 replays on Twitch. So I pulled it up the other day. So here's a race starting now. That is a treasury run race. They're basically just doing all the treasury runs on a cycle, so you can watch those live and kind of get a feel for, you know, the game itself. If you haven't seen it, you just go to Snail Trail Game on Twitch and you can see it there. Let's see what else. For rewards. So when you get your rewards into your from winning or coming in a certain place in the treasury, you won't see them immediately in your wallet. It can take anywhere between 5 minutes and 12 hours to actually go from your in-game balance to your actual wallet, which isn't a huge deal. You can claim them at any time. You just go back into, you know, the game itself. You do your pull down tab here. And then you can see that your pending reward balance is here. It tells you that it could take 12 hours for these to show up in your actual balance, so you can claim them. However, you don't really need to, because if you're using them to enter competitive races, they don't have to be in your wallet to use. So if you're claiming them, just have enough to use into a competitive race, don't worry about it. It'll deduct it from your rewards, so you won't even have to deal with it, and just wait out the time for them to show up in your wallet if you're trying to sell any or you're using for something else or sending to somebody. So that's not an issue. So don't worry about that. If they only show up here, it may take time for them to get there. Other than that, I think that's really the basic, you know, kind of rundown on Snail Trail. I've been a fan. I waited a long time for them to launch. It was a couple delays, and I like the game. I like the potential that it has to keep building. The team's been great. It's got great backing across the board. I think as they continue to develop new games, and as interest in player interaction continues to go higher, and as long as the marketplace continues to run, I think Snail Trail's got a great future on Avalaunch, as well as into kind of the next cycle. So I'm just going to keep going on my snails and racing them and developing them out and experimenting with breeding, just to help get more familiar with GameFi, breeding in general, and different ways that different games run things. So I'd say get a snail or two and experiment, have fun, and just enjoy it. And if you have any questions, please feel free at any time to reach out to me, either on Twitter at TradingAloha or through any medium, really. I'm more than happy to help anyone else out to get onboarded and talk through any issues or problems that might have when you're trying to get the game started. So hopefully this has been helpful and somewhat informative on a basic level. If there are ways that I could improve to help kind of guide these starting tutorials for some of these games into the system, or a game that you'd like to see checked out that hasn't been talked about a lot, please reach out to me on Twitter or the Avalaunch account, and we will definitely take a look at it. So I appreciate the time for tuning in, and I hope that you all have a great weekend here on the 4th of July, and I will talk to you next time.